हेलो टू एवरीवन, स्वागत है आप सबका मेरे यूट्यूब चैनल पर। इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट आर ओवर, राइट? नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाउ मेनी अनदर टर्म आर गोइंग टू कम इन दिस चैप्टर। आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द सेम टॉपिक पॉलीनोमियल, सेम चैप्टर पॉलीनोमियल फॉर 9th क्लास। सो वी विल सी हाउ मेनी मोर टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस चैप्टर, राइट? सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम गोइंग टू नोट इट डाउन ओवर हियर दैट हाउ मेनी टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू कवर, राइट, इन दिस चैप्टर, बिकॉज वी मस्ट नो दैट हाउ मेनी टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस चैप्टर। सो आई एम गोइंग टू लिस्ट इट आउट। सो द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इन दिस चैप्टर फॉर 9th क्लास इज फाइंडिंग value of any polynomial. Introduction part is over. Now we are continuing the same chapter polynomial for the 9th class. So in this line, the first topic inside this chapter is finding value of any polynomial, right? And the second one is finding zeros of any polynomial. And another topic in the same chapter, remainder and factor theorem. And the last one is factorization. The sequence is much more matter. I have listed out all the topic inside this chapter, right? So first topic we are going to see, finding value of any polynomial, right? Means if you are given any polynomial, let's see example, if you are given any polynomial Px is equal to 7x minus 3. It is a polynomial or not? Yes, it is a polynomial because variable power is positive integer. Positive integer means a whole number, right? So it is a polynomial. And now we are going to find the value of any polynomial. So I have taken one example, that is Px is equal to 7x minus 3. Now we are going to find the value of this polynomial at 2. Means how question will come? Question will come like that. You will be given a polynomial and question will be asked like that find the value of Px at x is equal to 2. Like this question will come, right? First part. And B part, they can ask at x is equal to 3. They can ask x at x is equal to 10. At any value, they can ask the value of polynomial. So now we are going to see how to calculate value of any polynomial at given value. So it's very simple that you can see over here, you are given x is equal to 2. It simple means that in the polynomial, wherever you will see x, in the place of x, simply you have to put the value that you are given. It means if I solve this part, so Px you are given 7x minus 3. Means, I told you, wherever you see x, you can see over here, x is over here, I'll put 2. X is over here, I'll simply put the value 2. Then minus 3, now you have to calculate this one. 7 to the 14, 14 minus 3, 11. So, value of this polynomial at x is equal to 2 will be 11. Right? I hope you understood. Let's see second example. At x is equal to 3, first we will write the original polynomial, that Px is equal to 7x minus 3. And I told you, wherever x is there, simply you have to throw the value. जहां पर भी x है, हमें सिर्फ वहां value फेंकना है. X मुझे यहां दिख रहा है, तो p 3. और कहां x दिख रहा भाई? यहां x दिख रहा है. X जगह में 3 minus 3, ठीक है? तो P3 is equal to 7 3 21 minus 3 will come 18, right? So value of this polynomial at x is equal to 3 will be 18. Another example, at x is equal to 10, at x is equal to 10, simply I told you, you have to put the value in the place of x only. Simply we have to throw the value, and what is the polynomial? 7x minus 3 means 7 into 10 minus 3 will become 70 minus 3 will become 67, means value of polynomial at 10 will be 67. Simply you have to throw the value, that's all. I hope it's very easy finding the value of any polynomial. Now we are moving on the second topic of this chapter, that is zeros of polynomial. I hope you understood finding value of any polynomial. Let's see another topic. So the second topic is zeros of polynomial. Zeros of polynomial. So the definition of zeros of polynomial is x is equal to a is a zero of polynomial of variable x. X is equal to a is a zero of polynomial px. ये कब होगा? If value of polynomial at a will be zero. Now you understood why we have completed the first topic, finding the value of polynomial. Means here we are finding the value of p at a, and if it is zero, right, then a will become zero of polynomial of variable x, and if it is not coming zero, so it will not be zero. अब हम डेफिनेशन तो समझ गए, अब हमें ये समझना है कि बेसिकली हम जीरोस फाइंड कैसे करते हैं, राइट? सो बेसिकली देयर आर टू मेथड टू फाइंड द जीरो ऑफ पॉलीनोमियल. क्योंकि आप बोलोगे ना, बोले हो डेफिनेशन तो बता दी, अब ये बताओ कि वैल्यू कैसे फाइंड करते हैं, राइट? कि जीरोस फाइंड कैसे करते हैं वो हम देखते हैं. जो पहला तरीका है जीरोस फाइंड करने का, वो तरीका है, मैं पहला तरीका बता रहा हूं, टू ऑब्टेन जीरोस ऑफ एनी पॉलीनोमियल. पहला तरीका है सॉल्विंग पॉलीनोमियल, सॉल्विंग पॉलीनोमियल इक्वेशन. ये पहला तरीका है टू ऑब्टेन जीरोस ऑफ एनी पॉलीनोमियल. दिस इज द फर्स्ट वे टू ऑब्टेन जीरोस ऑफ एनी पॉलीनोमियल. एंड व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट वे? What is the first way? Solving polynomial equation. मतलब आपको polynomial equation को solve करना है. मैं आपको तरीका बताता हूँ. अभी तो मैंने सिर्फ नाम बताया है, नाम के अंदर काम क्या है ये भी मैं आपको बताता हूँ. मतलब जैसा नाम बोला गया polynomial equation, मतलब अगर आपको px दिया हुआ है, ठीक है, px दिया हुआ है, px मतलब polynomial of variable x, ये आपको दिया हुआ है. अब आपको इसका find करना है zeros. तो यहां पे क्या बोला गया? सॉल्विंग पॉलीनोमियल इक्वेशन. पॉलीनोमियल तो हम जानते थे, लेकिन इक्वेशन क्या है? इक्वेशन मींस वी हैव टू पुट px इज इक्वल टू 0. अब बन गया ये इक्वेशन. इक्वेशन मतलब यही होता है कि जब बीच में इक्वल साइन आ जाए, ठीक है, मतलब px इज इक्वल टू 0. अब ये बन गया इक्वेशन, इसी को मुझे सॉल्व करना है. लेट्स सी एग्जांपल, राइट? I am going to take one example. By example, you will get clear picture of this method. You are given, let's see example, you are given px is equal to 7x minus 3. This is the equation, sorry, this is the polynomial you are given, 7x minus 3. It is a polynomial or not? Yes, it is a polynomial, as variable's power is the positive integer, means a whole number, right? Okay, so now we are going to find the zero of this given polynomial. So I told you, what is the way? The way is you have to put px equal to 0. This is the way, na? This is the method. And what is the value of Px? 7x minus 3 equal to 0. So 7x is equal to 3. 3 I have taken this side. Sign will be changed. If it is minus, it will become plus. Right? And now 7 is engaged with x with multiplication sign. That will go that side and it will come in upon. X is equal to 3 by 7. Right? So x is equal to 3 by 7 is 0 of this given polynomial. I hope you understood the first method. Another example I am taking, px you are given x square minus 5x plus 6. Let's see how to solve it. And we are going to solve this question by the first method only, solving polynomial equation. For that, what we have to do? Simply we have to put px is equal to 0, means px equal to 0. What is the value of px? What is you are given px? X square minus 5x plus 6 equal to 0. Now we have to solve it and we will get the value of x. So now we are going to calculate the zeros of this given equation. And we know that how to calculate the zeros of this given equation. How to calculate it? We have already studied in the 8th class, by middle term split, we can calculate the zeros of this given equation, right? So I'm going to show you that how to, you know, calculate the zeros of this given equation. X square minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. So first term and the last term you have to multiply. There is nothing in multiply, means 1 into 6 will come 6, and 6 you have to split such a way that plus or minus, right? You have to split 6 in a such a way so their factors summation or subtraction will come minus 5, and those will be minus 3x minus 2x plus 6, means minus 3 into minus 2 will become 6, and minus 3 minus 2 will become minus 5, right? So we are going to factorize it. X I take common, x minus 3 minus 2, x plus x minus 3 is equal to 0, x minus 2 and x minus 3. It means here one value. So x minus 2 into x minus 3 is equal to 0. 1 by 1 I put equal to 0. First of all I put x minus 2 is equal to 0. Value of x will come 2. So this is the first 0. And x minus 3 is equal to 0. So x will come 3. X is equal to 3 will become another 0. First 0 and second 0. Right? I have not explained very well how to do factorization, because that we are going to see in the last topic of this chapter. As I told you, factorization is the last topic, right, of this chapter. So there we will see in detail that how to do factorization, right? वहाँ पे हम देखेंगे. यहाँ पे हम सिर्फ मैं आपको ये दिखा रहा हूँ कि zeros कैसे calculate करते हैं by putting equal to 0. हमें px को 0 के equal रखना है, फिर उस equation को solve करना है, and in last you will get zeros. I hope you understood. This is the first method to obtain zero of any polynomial. And the second method to obtain zeros of the given polynomial is hit and trial method. Jaisa naam hai, waisa hi kaam hai. Hit and try means you have to choose a value aur usko usme try karna hai. Kisme polynomial? Polynomial mein try karna hai. और फिर देखना है कि पॉलीनोमियल की वैल्यू जीरो आ रही है नहीं आ रही. जो जीरो आ रही है तो वो जीरो बन जाएगा, जिसमें जीरो नहीं आ रही वो जीरो नहीं बनेगा. जैसा नाम है वैसा काम है, हिट एंड ट्राई. ठीक है, मतलब यहां पे अगर मैंने x इज इक्वल टू a लिया है, राइट, किसी पॉलीनोमियल के लिए, तो मैं पी ए कैलकुलेट करूंगा. मैं क्या कैलकुलेट करूंगा? पी ए कैलकुलेट करूंगा. और यहां पर दो ही कंडीशन हो सकती है, या तो पी ए की वैल्यू जीरो आएगी या पी ए की वैल्यू जीरो नहीं आएगी. इन दो के अलावा कोई केस हो सकता है क्या? नहीं हो सकता. अब बात यह आई, अगर ये केस हुआ तो यहां पे ए विल बिकम जीरो ऑफ गिवन पॉलिनोमियल. मतलब ए इज अ जीरो ऑफ पी एक्स, और इस कंडीशन में सेकेंड कंडीशन में क्या होगा, ए इज नॉट अ जीरो ऑफ पी एक्स। और अगर सेकेंड कंडीशन आती है तो आपको फिर से दूसरा नंबर चॉइस करना पड़ेगा, मतलब तब तक आपको हिट एंड ट्राई करना है अंटिल यू विल नॉट गेट पी ए इक्वल टू जीरो। लेट्स सी थ्रू बाय एग्जांपल, पी एक्स इज इक्वल टू सेवन एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस थ्री एक्स, राइट। सो आई एम गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट द जीरोस ऑफ दिस गिवन पॉलिनोमियल बाय हिट एंड ट्रायल मेथड। हिट एंड ट्रायल मेथड मतलब फिर से हमें वैल्यू लेना है, ट्राई करना है और देखना है कि पी इक्वल टू जीरो आ रहा है या नहीं आ रहा है। पी इक्वल टू जीरो आ रहा है मतलब वो जीरो बन जाएगा, नहीं आ रहा है तो अनदर वैल्यू मुझे चॉइस करनी पड़ेगी, राइट। तो यहां पे देखते हैं, मैं सबसे पहला एज अ हिट एंड ट्रायल मेथड में ले रहा हूं एक्स इज इक्वल टू टू, मतलब वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट पी टू पॉलिनोमियल वैल्यू एट टू, तो इज इक्वल टू सेवन इंटू टू स्क्वायर माइनस थ्री इंटू टू एंड सेवन सेवन फोर जा 28 माइनस सिक्स विल कम 22, राइट। एंड 22 मींस पी टू इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो, राइट, मींस एक्स इक्वल टू टू इज नॉट अ जीरो ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल ऑफ वेरिएबल x. So we have to choose the another number. Now this time I am going to take as a you know hit and try number 0. 0 itself I am taking. So p0 will come 7 into 0 square minus 3 into 0. So it will come 0 only. So now value of polynomial as 0 is coming 0. Right? It means, what it means? Means x is equal to 0 is a zero of p x, right? Okay, in the same case, in the same question, we are going to choose this time x is equal to 3 by 7, right? So once we will calculate p 3 by 7, it will also come 0 only. You can put it 3 by 7, you can put over here, right, in the place of x, definitely it will come 0, right. And if it will come 0, so x is equal to 3 by 7 will become 0 of px, 0 of px. I hope you are understanding these all. So I am summarizing over here how to obtain zeros of any polynomial. So there are two methods. The first method is solving polynomial equation, means by putting simply px is equal to 0, you can calculate the equation and you will get zeros. Another method is hit and trial method, means you have to choose the different values and you have to put into the polynomial, and if it is coming 0, so that value and that particular number will become zeros of given polynomial, and if it is not, then we have to choose the another number.